Hi friends, in this video we are going to apply superposition theorem to a simple problem. So let's take a problem. So here we have taken a problem where sources are more but only one resistance is present. So let's have the value to these sources. So this voltage source is of 6 volt, this current source 5 ampere, voltage source of 10 volt and only resistance present of 5 ohm. We are supposed to find out voltage between points A and B, that is VAB, using superposition theorem. So let's start. First, I will consider only one source acting alone. So I will consider 6 volt acting alone. Remaining sources, that is 5 ampere, a current source, and we have discussed current source we need to open circuit. So 5 ampere is open circuited. And 10 volt, another voltage source, that I will short circuit. Since modification is made to the original circuit, we need to redraw it. So I will have 6 volt acting alone, so this will be present. Remember, we are not touching resistance at all, so that will also remain as it is. Current source is open circuit and voltage source is short circuited. So I will get a circuit having only source 6 volt present and a resistance 5 ohm. If you see properly, from this point A to point B, I am having a voltage source connected which is 6 volt, and 5 ohm is across the 6 volt. So I can say directly VAB equal to 6 volt, and VAB is a partial answer because I have considered only one source. So I will consider VAB dash as a notation. So this will be your answer directly. Let's go to the second step. In the second step, I will consider second voltage source, that is 10 volt. So 10 volt acting alone, 6 volt is a voltage source, we will short circuit that. So 6 volt is short circuited. And 5 ampere is a current source, we need to open circuit it. Because of this, there is modified circuit. So 6 volt is short circuited. Once again, we are not touching resistance at all, so that will be as it is. 5 ampere open circuited, and only source acting this time is 10 volt. So I will get resultant circuit like this. Again, I need to consider this loop which is covering A and B points. So in this loop, since it is open circuited here at point A as well as at point B, current flowing through 5 ohm resistance will be 0 ampere because it is not closed. So obviously, whatever voltage source is present, that will be the voltage across points A and B. So here also I can directly say VAB double dash, because it is only because of 10 volt acting alone, 10 volt. Second answer I am getting. Third step, let's consider 5 ampere acting alone. Now, remaining sources are voltage sources. I need to short circuit them. So, 6 volt and 10 volt are short circuited. So, the modified circuit diagram will look like this. 6 volt is shorted. Resistance will remain as it is. Only source acting is a current source of 5 ampere. And this 10 volt is also short circuited. Now, in order to get voltage between these two points, I should know current flowing through the 5 ohm resistance as well as number of elements coming in this loop. Here only 5 ohm resistance will come into the picture. So, I should find out what is the current flowing through 5 ohm resistance. You cannot say current flowing through the 5 ohm resistance is 5 ampere because 5 ohm resistance is actually short circuited because of this link. So, actually speaking, you will get a loop like this. From A, it will bypass 5 ohm resistance and it will come back to this B point like this. So, it is just a wire bypassing 5 ohm resistance. So, I can say voltage of points A and B, which I will denote as I triple dash AB, will be 0 volt. Now, you may be wondering what will happen to this 5 ampere current. 5 ampere current will flow through this part of the circuit. It will just circulate over here. Since I am not having any resistance in this part, therefore, there won't be any voltage drop despite of a current source present. It will just circulate in this loop. So, ultimately, I will get VAB dash, or I should say VAB triple dash, as 0 volt. Finally, as per the statement of superposition theorem, the response here, response is a voltage between points A and B, will be the algebraic sum of response because of first source, response because of second source, and response because of third source. Since in all the three answers, I am getting answer VAB, where A is positive with respect to B. So, I can simply add all the responses. So, 6 volt plus 10 volt plus 0 volt, and finally VAB, I will get 16 volt. And here I can add one more line to complete answer. I am getting this answer when A positive with respect to B. So, whenever voltage is asked, you better write down this statement, which point is positive with respect to which point, and in case of a current as a response, we will denote direction along with a magnitude. So, here we have seen a numerical having 3 sources present and only 1 resistance, but actually the answers are very simple. It will be just a simple concepts that we have already learned. In subsequent videos, we will solve more numericals based on superposition theorem. Thank you.